Hello, this is History Shorts with the Artifactual Scholar. Today, I'll be talking about suffragist and women's rights advocate Dr. Mabel Pinghua Lee. Since 1848, women in the United States have been engaged in a struggle for political and social equality. In the 19th century, the banner of women's suffrage was carried by Elizabeth Cady Stanton and Susan B. Anthony, among others. But as the new century dawned, new leaders such as Alice Paul, Lucy Burns, and Carrie Chapman Catt continued to push for progress. Mabel Pinghua Lee was one of those 20th century suffragists. Lee was born in Guangzhou, China, and emigrated with her mother to the United States in 1905, when she was about 9. Her father, Dr. Li To, a Baptist missionary assigned to New York's Chinatown, had preceded the family to the United States several years before. The Li family's journey was rare for that time because the U.S. had passed several laws, such as the Chinese Exclusion Act of 1882, that largely barred Asians from entering the country. Despite the fact that her ethnicity barred her from citizenship, Mabel Lee was drawn to the suffragist cause. By the time she was 16, she had gained recognition and raised eyebrows for her support of women's rights. In May 1912, she rode in the Mounted Honor Guard at the head of the New York City Suffrage Parade. The parade featured nearly 10,000 participants and was an important event in the suffrage movement. In the fall of that year, she enrolled at Barnard College and continued to vocally and actively support women's rights, both in the United States and in China. At that time, China was itself undergoing dramatic political and social change. The old imperial regime had been overthrown by revolution in 1911. Lee hoped that the suffrage movement in the U.S. could be a springboard for improving women's rights in China. Simultaneously, she wanted to engage the Chinese American population to support the education and political rights of women. After graduating from Barnard, Lee continued with her studies and in 1921 earned a PhD in economics from Columbia University, the first Chinese American woman to do so. One of her goals was to return to China to establish a school for girls, but her father's death in 1924 forced a change in her plans. Dr. Lee took direction of her father's ministry at the First Chinese Baptist Church and then established the Chinese Christian Center, a civic organization that provided childcare, vocational training, and language classes to the community. Women in the United States finally gained the right to vote with the ratification of the 19th Amendment in 1920. Despite that, and despite all of her accomplishments, Dr. Lee and other Chinese Americans were still disenfranchised by federal law. In fact, it wasn't until 1943 that Asian Americans could become U.S. citizens. Yet, she persevered in the righteousness of her beliefs and continued to work for the benefit of her community. The suffragists and women's rights campaigners of the early 20th century all faced resistance as they strove for political and social equality. But some, such as Zitkala Shah, Jovita Idar, and Ida B. Wells, had to stand tall in the face of institutional racism as well. Like them, Dr. Mabel Pinghua Lee had to overcome stereotypes and perceptions to become a voice for women and for Chinese Americans. In many ways, Mabel Pinghua Lee's story is a typical American story. She challenged societal norms, broke barriers for herself and others, and like many immigrants before and since, endeavored to make this country a better place. This has been History Shorts. Thanks for watching.